I'm Amy from eSpares, and in this video I'll be teaching you all you need to know about appliance energy rating labels. Many household appliances come with an appliance energy rating label, including white goods such as refrigerators, washing machines and tumble dryers. The purpose of these energy rating labels is to tell you exactly how much energy your appliance uses and to tell you how energy efficient it is. Energy rating labels are useful because they help you save money, be more mindful of your energy output, and make environmentally friendly decisions when buying appliances. The more energy efficient your home appliances are, the lower your utility bills will be. Energy efficient appliances also reduce the amount of harmful gases released into the environment, making them more beneficial for everyone. For some time now, energy rating labels have used a rating system that ranges from A++ to D, with A++ being the most efficient and D being the least efficient. They also display an estimate of how much energy your appliance will use on a yearly basis. This is summed up in kilowatt hours, which is often displayed like this. However, this letter rating system that's shown here is now outdated because over 90% of new products had an A++ rating, which made it quite hard for people to decide which products were the most energy efficient. That's why this letter rating system was updated in March 2021. The new updated energy rating label will be rated from A to G. This is to allow for new and improved appliances that will be even more energy efficient than the ones we use today. For example, an appliance that had an energy rating of A++ may only have a rating of C on the new label. Now let's take a closer look at specific appliance energy rating labels from March 2021 onwards. Because every appliance is used to do a unique job, the tests used to determine and understand their energy efficiency are very different from each other. The energy rating labels will also include information specific to each appliance. For example, the energy rating label for a fridge will look quite different to the energy rating label for a washing machine. So let's start with the fridge. After central heating, refrigeration products are the second least efficient appliances around your home. That's why it's so important to make sure that you choose the right product for you. The new energy rating labels will also use the A to G rating system, and they'll feature a few new icons, including the chilled and unfrozen compartments, and also the one for noise emissions. The energy rating of a fridge is calculated by comparing the energy usage to the internal volume. This means that even with the new rating system, the energy rating can vary from product to product. For example, a smaller fridge with a C rating can use less energy than a larger fridge with a better B rating. You can compare how much electricity is used by appliances of different sizes by comparing the yearly kilowatt hour energy usage. The energy rating label also takes into consideration how low the temperature gets in each compartment and if it has a frost-free setting. Now let's talk washing machines. As well as your A to G rating, the new energy rating labels will also include how much energy is used in 100 washes. Additional features will also include how long an eco wash cycle takes, the weight capacity of your machine, noise emissions, and also water consumption. Water consumption will make a difference to your bills too, so here's a quick tip. The new energy rating labels will show how much water your machine uses over the course of a year. As a general guide, anything that uses less than 12,000 litres in the course of a year is considered to be really good. The efficiency of your washing machine is determined by how much energy it uses in the course of a year. This is measured by kilowatt hours and is based on a 40 degree wash and a 60 degree wash. Next, we have tumble dryers and washer dryers. As well as your A to G ratings, your energy rating label will also include features like the energy usage of 100 cycles, the noise emission classes of spinning, the weight capacity of your machine, and the duration of cycles. And for washer dryers, the water consumption will also be featured, just like your washing machine. Then we have new labels for dishwashers. On top of the A to G energy rating, there will also be information related to your eco settings, including the duration of a cycle, the amount of water used in litres, and how much energy is used for 100 cycles. There will also be a new icon to show the noise emissions of the machine. The energy rating of a dishwasher is calculated by comparing how much water is consumed compared to how much energy is consumed by the machine. However, it is important to bear in mind that dishwashers do consume a lot of water and energy, therefore it is harder for manufacturers to achieve the highest score compared to with other appliances. And finally, we have ovens. Like every other appliance we've looked at today, these are scored using the A to G rating system. And the energy efficiency scoring is calculated in a similar way to fridges, in that the internal space is compared to the amount of energy needed to heat a brick to 55 degrees Celsius. The less energy needed to heat the brick, the better the efficiency score will be. And there you have it, all you need to know about the new energy label rating system. Thank you for watching this video to the end, and I hope you've got a good understanding now of how energy label rating systems work. Please give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and subscribe to our channel for more helpful advice on appliances, repairs, and general knowledge. Before you go, feel free to check out the playlist below on energy saving tips for your home appliances so you can make them as energy efficient as possible. Thanks for watching!